Ja jestem Piotrek z NetGuru i dzisiaj opowiem Wam o rzeczy trudnej i nieciekawej. Nie będzie, będzie zero kodu, będzie o tym, że trzeba mówić do klientów, do naszych szefów i do ludzi. I będzie bardzo trudno, ponieważ tą prezentację przygotowałem na Wrocław, RB i niestety będzie ona po angielsku, a właściwie po anglikańsku, ponieważ mój angielski nie jest very fluent. Więc mam nadzieję, że mnie zrozumiecie i jakoś wspólnie dam radę. So, few years ago, I thought, if I'm a developer, the only thing I have to do is writing good code. I'm a nerd, so I don't need to talk to people. I have project manager to do that, and so on. But life showed me that was wrong. I have bad news for all of you. Even if you are a developer, you need to develop your soft skills. You can ask me, why the heck? There are three main reasons why you should develop your soft skill and be good at communication. First of all, the main reason are clients. In today's world, we usually use agile methodology, and all developers have contact with the client. And client is a human, and we have to talk to him. And of course, we and the client are the same team, but sometimes we have different goals. The biggest threat of fight with client is time estimating. We have to be able to persuade him why we need 1 month to do something when he thinks it require only 1 week. And also, if you are a good developer, you should be able to defend client for himself. Because sometimes client has stupid ideas about new features. And you have to be able to talk to him, it's a crap. And you have to do that the way he understands that and feel happy with that, not feel stupid. The next reason to develop soft skills are your boss and coworkers. And again, it's the same team with you, but sometimes we have different goals. You maybe like your boss, maybe your boss like you, but it's your task to fight for your money, for your salary. Of course, your salary depends on your developer skills, but I can say it's also a correlation with your soft skills. If you are good at talking, that you are able to say to your boss that your value is higher and you need more money. And I know cases when very good developers who are shy, who are not able to talk very well, and their salaries are usually lowest than not the best ones, but who are able to talk, who are very, how to say that, get at living. And also, communication skills are very important when you are part of the company, not a freelancer, part of the team, because you work with other people in the office, and it's good to have good atmosphere in the office. If there's a good atmosphere and you like your team and your time like you, then you can focus on your job and you feel good at this place. And if you are good at communication, you can ask other people for help, maybe sometimes to do your job. And also they will feel happy with that. So it's important to develop this skill. And next reason is that developers are also humans. And humans live with other people, we like societies, and we have relationships with other people. And it's also all about communication. I don't know your experience, but I have some situations when I was in relationship, and I love the girl. The girl loves me, but we break up because we are not able to communicate with each other. And if you are happy at your home, you are also happy at your job. You can concentrate just on your task, and your career will develop. So we know the reasons why we should develop these skills. Now is the hardest part, how to do that. And it's not easy. It's required a lot of effort, and you should start with talking to people. It's all about practice, practice, and practice. If you learn new technology, new programming language, you wrote the simplest app, Hello World. And the same with communication. If you are a beginner, you should start with hi. You are going to shop, say how to shopper, say hi to people on the bus station, or maybe if you don't know people on the conference like this, just say hi, my name is Peter, how are you? The simplest thing. After that, when you are able to write your hello world, you can go further and maybe talk about weather. It's also quite easy. After weather, we can talk maybe about new movies, last Champions League match, and so on. Now, about helpers. Alcohol is something that can help us a lot. Because if you are shy and you are not able to talk to other people, it is because you are thinking what other people will think about you when you start talking. You are a nerd, you spend a lot of years on computers, and you don't know how people behave. You don't know the rules. And when you are drunk, you don't care about rules. You just act, you just start talking. And I know cases when the guy was very, very shy, not even talk a word a day, but when he was drunk, he was the king of the party, he picked up girls, and so on. And maybe, okay, it's also a dangerous way, because you know you can be addicted, but maybe someday you will wake up and you think like this, okay, I can talk to people when I'm drunk, so maybe I can also try when I'm not drunk. And we are developers, and developers are very smart guys who have some ideas in their head. Who of you have some idea about startup, new product, and so on? Raise your hand. Okay. There is a few people, and if you want to do something more than write a code, you have to develop your public speaking. And this one is really, really hard because all eyes are look at you. And like American scientists say, the fears against public speaking is the biggest one in the world. People are more frightened of public speaking than that. That is why not many people are able to do that. And I will tell you my story with public speaking. A few years ago, I was living in Łódź, not so beautiful town in Poland, and there is an event called BoatCamp. It was an IT bar camp. Some guys make a presentation about IT subjects, and other people drink beers, ask questions, and make networking. And usually, at these meetings, I have some questions in my head to these people, but I wasn't able to ask these questions. And I had three very strong reasons why to not ask questions. First of all, I was afraid if I raise my hand, the speaker will not notice that and won't give me a voice, and I will be rejected. It's not a good feeling. That is why I was just sitting on my chair and just fighting in my head. And sometimes I was very close to win that battle, but that was the second reason. I am a guy who is speaking very, very fast, and it's very hard to understand me. So I thought, even if this guy give me a voice, I will nervous and I will speak very, very fast and nobody understands me. The guy asked me to repeat, I will moan, speak even faster and nobody will understand me. I will feel rejected again. So I was still sitting and fighting in my head. And I was close to win, but there was the next reason. The biggest one and the stupidest one. I thought, okay, maybe they give me a voice, maybe they understand me, but maybe my question is stupid. And I never ask questions. And at one of the boss camp, there was a guy from Warsaw, from Startup Weekend, and he offered us the tickets for a guy who will just write an email, not have to speak, write an email, why he should want this ticket. And I write one mail, and I won. I go to Warsaw, and week before that was very hard for me, because Startup Weekend is about pitching. If you have idea, you have to start with very short pitch about your idea. After that is voting for the best ideas. And if you won the vote, you complete your team and work on your idea. So I was preparing my pitching all the week. I went to Warsaw. And then they told me I have to make my speech in English. I was prepared in Polish, so I thought, okay, it's not my fault, they want English. I was prepared in Polish. I don't have to make this speech. I can just make someone else's idea alive. But there is a voice in my head. Hey, guy, it's a weekend. You can spend this time with your friends on party, with your girlfriend. You are here to make your idea alive. So I decide to make a speech. It was very, very hard. And after this speech was voting. There was something like 200 people. All people have three voices, and I get them only a few. Only the people I already know. So it was such a big failure. I decided I have something to do with that. I have to be able to convince people to my ideas. So I decided to join Toastmasters. Toastmasters is an organization that have almost 90 years. It was established in USA, but now it's all around the world. There are hundreds of thousands of people that are learning public speaking and leadership in Toastmasters. And basic idea of Toastmasters is that all of other members are your friends. There are no stupid questions. You have your voice, and you can get familiar with the topic. There is 10 projects to learn you how to make public speaking. The first one is just go on stage and start talking about anything. In the next projects, you learn how to use your body, your voice, about speech structure, and so on. And Toastmasters is a sandbox. You can develop your skills in friendly atmosphere. Of course, you get feedback from your mates, but it's always positive and constructive. They begin with something that you are good at to make you feel good. Next, they talk about something you can improve to challenge you to make a progress. And they also finish with something good. At the beginning, I was terrible. But people talk to me, okay, you are very good. It's amazing. And when I go back from my first speeches on video, and I look at this, it's really horrible. But the faith of other people make me able to fight with my fears. So I recommend you to join Toastmasters. There are 5 clubs in Warsaw. 3 of them are Polish, and 2 are English-speaking. Okay, but Toastmasters is only a sandbox, and if you are not regular, typical nerd, maybe you are able to talk to people without this. I wasn't. And when I finished with Toastmasters, I decided to go from the sandbox and start to talk to normal people. And you should start it with the small steps. The smallest step is to ask questions on conferences. As I told you, I was able to do that. But after 1 month in Toastmasters, and after I made 2 speeches, I was able to do that. It was in Warsaw, the conference was called Aula Polska. And I can't wait to the end of the first presentation to ask questions, because I feel my fears disappear. And when speaker finished his talk, I raised my hand. And the speaker gave me a voice. So my first fear disappeared. I was very happy. I stand up, thanks him for his presentation, and ask her a question. And what is so hard for me, this guy understands what I'm talking about. So it was great, and what's more, he answered my question. So this question wasn't stupid. All my fears disappeared. And after that, one of organizers said, the CD Projekt is a sponsor of this meeting, and the most active people from Athens, Widonia, will won Witcher the second, the game. So I decide I will. And after the next presentation, I also ask questions. I ask stupid questions that I know the answer. But again, the speaker answered to me, and he gave me a game. So it was my first trophy, first sign for God, public speaking is something good. So today we have 3 speeches, and after each of them, we have questions as well. It is the time when you ask your questions. I know you will have some questions in head, and the question will be stupid, but just ask them. The next bigger step are lightning talks. Lightning talks are quite easy, because you're on stage only for a few minutes, and you are talking about the subjects you like. And again, we have lightning talks today, so you will have a chance to practice this. After lightning talks, you should go further and make a full presentation, not just a few minutes. But of course, it's hard, so you should start with an environment you like. So maybe in your company or maybe on meetings like this. And after that, you will be able to conquer the world, to say to people your ideas and change their lives, change the world. But to do that, you have to start right here and right now. And I know after these meetings, we'll go to drink these 3 beers. And all of you will talk each other about some technical stuff. And always when I'm hearing people like you, I feel very, very stupid, because the level of your knowledge and experience are very, very high. But I don't know why you are pricks and don't share this knowledge with each other. I know all of us have some troubles, some hard tasks in our job every day. And I'm sure that there is some guy on this room that know the answer about your troubles from last day. But he is a prick and don't want to share this knowledge. And the same with you. You have the answers for some other questions, but you don't want to make a lightning talk to help each other people, because you're also a prick. But it's easy to solve. You can stop your prick in just a few minutes. It's just to decide to talk today about some technical stuff, maybe a new gem, maybe an article you read last days, last weeks, about something you share with your colleagues in job, and you should also share with all of us today. So guys,